Live from inside Portia, Colorado Springs, it's the First Dibs Podcast with our hosts, John Dicey and Justin Underwood. Buckle up and let's go for a ride.
Don't change the station. It's the First Dibs Podcast.
That's right.
It's Friday and we're live. And I think I waited long enough where you'll actually see us.
Yeah.
This first little bit got cut off, but you never know. It's John and Justin. We're here live in the Portia, Colorado Springs pre-owned showroom with our friends Ryan and Jason from Colorado Cars and Coffee. They run their newsletter. So if you guys are in Colorado and want to know what's going on, sign up and then you'll get all kinds of information.
Please subscribe.
So yeah, I think they do a great job. They take way more time and way more care than we do putting on what we do. You know, this show for us is probably 2 hours of work total every week.
Yeah.
And that's like an hour for you and an hour for me.
Right.
Right. Mm-hmm. That's very evenly split.
Okay. Yeah. Well, then I am going to agree that we put in a little more time.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah. Yeah, no, that wasn't tongue in cheek. That was absolutely, that was props and respect because this is just off the cuff. Mm-hmm. And if I say something wrong, I don't even have to go back and edit it. Whereas in the newsletter, you got to at least make sure you spell there and there right.
Yeah. Or if we put up an event that didn't occur.
Oh,
we've had one
did
or two.
You do that?
We've had we put them up because when we find them, they're going on.
Uh-huh.
And then you know, if weather cancels or something happens, we actually had a guy get rather upset that it was twice in a row he went to an event and it wasn't going on. But the second time he went on the wrong day, so that one was
so it wasn't totally all right. Well, that's good.
Turns out people on the internet get upset when you know things don't go their way.
Yeah, right.
Like to talk about it.
Yeah,
on the internet.
Well, John did something similar.
What did I do?
Was that a couple of years ago? We were throwing a semi-private, casual party with some friends, but they were bringing Usher.
That's true. That's true. We did host a party for Usher.
Not someone who was an Usher.
No, the Usher.
An Usher.
Yeah. I should have been tipped off when he had a residence in Vegas for those same days. But
good.
Anyway,
it turns out he was pre-booked. Sorry.
Yeah, exactly.
But I mean, a lot of people showed up.
It was a good party.
Yeah, it was a good party.
Good party.
Yeah. For two dweebs, you know, at the store being able to host, you gotta get away with it.
We competed with the fan fest for Pikes Peak Hill Climb.
That's right.
Oh, wow.
And you know, they probably drew more people. But
probably,
I don't know. We had a better DJ.
We had a way better DJ. Yeah, we had a way better DJ.
Yeah.
We just have a better venue.
That's true.
So, yeah. By we, I mean, I think Portia, Colorado Springs for letting us borrow the venue.
Yeah.
Yeah. But anyway.
So I think what we normally do is we talk about business and things that are the whole reason people listen. Mm-hmm. So what we'd like to do is get the important stuff out of the way so people can turn us off.
Mm-hmm.
And then when we goof off, there are less people paying attention to get us in trouble.
That's right.
So off the top of my head, there's a 2022 Targa 4 GTS in chalk with a blue top, graphite blue interior, chalk seat centers, chalk stitching, dynamic chassis control, rear steering, Burmester stereo, leather door sills, leather door panels, leather dash,
matte carbon fiber trim.
Yep. Carbon mirrors.
Yes.
Front axle lift. Did I miss anything? It's chalk. Did I say that?
Carbon leather chalk.
God, that car, that's like one of those, the guy was, just picked everything. It was check every box. I don't, you know, yes, I want it.
Yeah.
I'll take it. That sounds good. Is there anything I missed, John? Oh, you didn't put a fire extinguisher there. Okay, put the fire extinguisher in there. Yeah, but it might as well do that. So
right. For your Ferrari and Maserati, of course. Not
for you that. Nailed it. 3,500 miles. If I remember right.
Yeah.
Right in that range.
Yep.
That's super cool.
Yeah.
It's the new 3 liter. How Porsche are you guys? I know you've got a Porsche. How Porsche freak are you on a scale of 1 to 10?
Freak? 6, 7.
Okay.
Wow. Always, okay. That's always pretty good. had a thing for Porsches. Yep. My mother will appreciate me mentioning that, my father and her had an old bathtub Porsche.
Okay.
I really liked.
Very cool.
I actually took a couple photos of some of the ones out back that I'll have to share with her later.
Okay, yeah, very cool.
Yeah, we have a beautiful restored 59 356A on the other showroom floor.
Yeah.
Oh. That's a cool one to check out. So.
That's the one. Mm-hmm. That's the one I'd take. The Emery, but the Emery's gone.
That's gone.
Ooh. So, the GTSs are a 3 liter, 473 horsepower. This one's all-wheel, it's a Targa. All the Targas are all-wheel drive. It's a PDK car. A GTS comes with the sport exhaust with black exhaust tips. They even check the box that adds a silver tip around the black tip.
Right.
You know,
I need the trim.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
That is exactly right. Mm-hmm. So
there's a meme in there somewhere.
Yes, exactly. Uh-huh.
Yep.
You can't double stamp a triple stamp.
Isn't
that,
right.
Isn't that the thing? Mm-hmm. What is that? I don't know. I remember that one. I got a couple pre-first dibs, but I don't think we should share those because then I won't have anything to talk about next week. Mm. Did we talk about the Blackwing?
No, I don't know.
There's a black Blackwing.
Yeah.
Manual transmission. I think they should have just called it the Chevy Impala. Because I think that to me, do you guys know the Chevy Impala? Like the 94 to 96 Impala SSs?
Oh, yeah.
To me, that's what the Blackwing is now, right? Mm-hmm. It's a Corvette motored rear-wheel drive super sports car.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know. I feel like you could have just done that and brought Chevy up.
668 horsepower.
That's good.
654 pound-feet of torque.
Mm-hmm. Supercharged, right?
Supercharged V8, 6.2 liter.
Yeah.
Is it the ZR1 engine? Corvette ZR1
I think
engine?
That sounds right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Corvette people are probably going to get
that. Yeah. There are no Corvette people. Oh, yeah. No, we're okay. This is a Porsche podcast.
Right, right. And then the description. I was writing descriptions today for cars that are about to populate the website.
Mm-hmm.
I had a little bit of fun with that one. You'll just have to wait.
Let's go read it.
Says.
Okay. Yeah. That sounds good. We'll do that.
I'll probably get in trouble. I'll get some crap. You know, like some regular person that just looks at every single description that we have of every car every day, they'll call.
Well, what is this? Didn't we write?
I thought you're a professional establishment.
Yeah, didn't we write one that said, like, is there mustard on your wife beater? Are you wearing gold chains?
This car was for you.
Should you shave your chest, but you haven't yet?
Do you wear Fila track suits?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Then I've got the car for you.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Come down to Justin and John's Car Emporium, 911 Motor City Drive, and we will hook you up.
Right.
It's in the back of the Porsche store.
I think those were vocal ads. They weren't
That didn't ever got
they
written
weren't
down.
In print.
All right.
It's your version of Deal and Doug.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, my gosh, yeah. But no, that's a pretty amazing
car. It's a sweet
car.
It's got like the lighter interior. It's almost a white interior like some red stitching and
It's called I think it's called like cool gray or something like that with black accents.
Is it manual or an auto?
Yeah, manual. It's a manual.
Six-speed manual.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Chef's kiss.
That'll do some burnouts.
Oh my God. Oh.
Yeah. James.
I forgot to turn on the microphones.
No, you didn't.
No, just kidding.
James went out and drove it. When he came back, the detail, Brian said, how is it? What do you think of it? He says, I just want to scream America when I drive it.
Yeah. It's like going to an air show.
Yeah.
You know, like when the F-35 flies by. Mm-hmm. It's like, oh, yep, I'm American. Thank God.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yep. Roast a couple sets of Pirellis or Michelin. Mm-hmm. I don't know.
I think you got to do Goodyears or Firestones.
Firestones.
Probably Firestones.
Firestones.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's a good one.
Mm-hmm.
You missed out on the Prowler. That one, it sounds like, is going away.
I think
You only had 9 months.
It wasn't here that long.
Well, felt like it.
I mean, they're so rare, right? Mm-hmm.
I think they made 11,000 of them is what we were chatting about, which I think is a good number because it's enough where there's parts and it's few enough where it still feels pretty special.
But no trailer. That's the
this
real,
one. There's no trailer. That's shh. If the guy's listening, it hasn't left yet. Although he did send us money, so we should be fine.
Your check is cleared.
Getting a Chalk Macan 2022.
Okay.
I think that's super fresh. Really great beautiful, amazing condition. I think it's only got about 18,000 miles on it, if I'm not mistaken. That one got traded in actually late tonight.
Mm-hmm.
What else?
The 911 Cabriolet, not the one that just came in, because that one's going away, but there's the, like, the black and tan interior car.
It's a 21. I think it's a 21 Carrera S cab. Carrara white metallic and black Mojave beige interior.
Mm-hmm.
Really great build. I mean, it's a nice equipment, and I think it's only got 17,000 miles. It's been a Colorado car. That's a super cool. That's a good find. And we're getting convertibles.
Mm-hmm. Which, it's funny how it comes in waves. You know, we had like six Targas.
Tis the season.
And they're almost gone.
Mm-hmm.
And now the cabs are coming back.
Right. Mm-hmm.
I think we're getting a GT3 Touring upgrade,
yes.
Right?
Yes.
Arctic gray with the...
No, it's not Arctic. Agate.
Oh,
Agate
oh
gray.
That one. That it's, was a great car.
Yeah, over black and Cohiba interior.
Yeah.
Cohiba.
Is it black and Cohiba?
It's got to be, yeah.
I think so, yeah.
Delicioso.
Oh, man. This car, it's super, it is. It's very cool.
Yeah.
No, there's some great stuff. I mean, the people that are coming in today, we had a couple from Aspen that were just in town for business or something like that, and because they don't have a dealership like this there, you know, they feel like stopping by, and they're always impressed, you know, with what we got. So
I got one more for you.
Mm-hmm.
2013 Cayenne diesel.
Oh, that's right.
130,000 miles.
Mm-hmm.
Turn it into your off-road overlander. Yep. Mm-hmm.
Light bars.
Yep.
Yeah.
That should be here sometime next week. So that's a little pre-first dibby.
Oh, that is.
But
there's actually a guy down the street from me that has a Safari Porsche.
Oh, cool.
Done up. It's lifted, light bars, you know, all the extra goodies.
911 or a Cayenne?
I believe it's a Cayenne.
Okay. Cool. Mm-hmm. Very cool. Yeah. Yep. Mm-hmm. Those are good.
They're fun.
They're
great trucks for it, for sure.
You remember when the Touareg V10 diesel came out?
Oh, yeah.
Those things were tanks.
Yeah.
Tanks. Mm-hmm. I remember some guy, I was a waiter at a restaurant somewhere over in high school, and some guy in our town had one, and just like, it was cool. I mean, that was like the Piëch era. Mm-hmm. Volkswagen was just like, oh, my God, diesels, V8 diesels. W8 Passats. Come on.
Right,
what's cooler than that?
They made a wagon version of that too, I think, right? A manual W8 all-wheel drive.
Oh yeah.
Wagon.
Wow. What am I?
Say no more.
With 200 horsepower.
Right. Because it was what, 2003?
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Oh, your M3 showed up.
I know. It did.
Yeah.
Yeah, that thing's sweet. You know what it came with?
Wheels.
Zuckerman head sticker.
No way.
Yep.
Already on?
Tucked in the visor I wonder how closely they're going to check this thing in. And yeah,
that's so pretty fun.
No, that's cool.
What's the name of the color? How do you pronounce the? It's like Shakira orange. What's it called?
I think Shakira. Yeah, yeah.
Her hips don't.
Yeah,
lie.
Yeah.
Neither.
That sounds right.
Neither does your CPO evaluation process, apparently, because you found it so very thorough.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Yeah. Very thorough. No. We checked that thing out. I drove it. Loved it. Super cool. That the motor is a turbo 6 from BMW is a very torquey thing.
Sure.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So that was cool. Actually, that leads us into a next line of conversation.
Well, did we mention the S8?
No.
Oh my God.
That was a Saturday. Oh God, this thing is so good.
Oh man.
2017 S8 Plus.
Ooh.
17,000 miles.
Yeah.
Wow. Cream puff.
And it's limoed out.
Oh,
so it's black on black on black.
Long wheelbase.
I don't know if it's a long wheelbase. I don't know. I don't
it
know if
looks
they made
like it.
It's very big.
Mm-hmm.
But the center console in the back, like if you lay down the armrests, they've hidden a cup holder and the climate controls
for the
rear seat in the center armrest.
Mm-hmm.
So it just
what's the license plate to put on it? Do you remember?
Oh, I don't.
Mob boss.
Well, oligarch.
Oh, yeah. Ollie G. O-L-I-G.
Not Ollie G.
Not Ollie. Yeah, exactly. Ollie G.
Rolling around oligarchin.
Yep. Uh-huh. You got to put the little, like, diplomatic flags on the front.
Yeah, on the fenders. Yeah.
Yeah.
I wonder what country would you pick if you were going to oligarch for a country? I'd be Poland because I'm half Polish.
Okay.
So I just have to be. It's a red and white flag. It's very simple.
Mm-hmm. I don't know. I'd probably do like Zimbabwe.
Mm.
Croatia.
Okay.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, probably go off whatever's got a cool flag.
All right.
Kind of like how I buy wine. I look at the label.
What's the country in Coming to America?
Oh, there you go.
That's a great question. That
is it real or is it a made up movie company?
No, it's made up. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's like Wakanda or something. But it's not Wakanda. Right.
Yeah. Maybe that's what it would be. I'd do something like that. Because I'm not a real oligarch, right? So make up some fictitious. Yeah,
there you go.
But anyway.
Justin Bill.
Yeah.
Yeah. Is that enough businesses?
That's a lot of business.
Okay. That was 15 minutes of.
We have to save some.
Is your business your pleasure or your pleasure your business? That's the real question.
We don't work.
Yeah.
So I think. I think our business is happy.
As my friend Jesse once said, that half to one, six dozen to the other.
Yeah.
When he meant to say six to one, half dozen to the other. Yeah. There you go. Right. Yeah, it's all the same.
Yeah. I'll take the six dozen. That feels like work.
Right.
Yeah.
Where were you? We were segueing to something you said.
I've been having a dilemma about my car.
Which car?
Well, any car that I own, period.
This is true.
The whole history of my life.
This is true.
I think I've been satisfied with two cars in my life.
I heard one tonight.
Well, maybe three cars. I had a 91 Volvo 940 Turbo with the Turbo Plus kit. Lowering springs and Bilstein suspension.
Yeah.
That car was awesome. Nice. It was 1998 or so. So it was still fairly fresh.
Mm-hmm.
It was 181 horsepower, which then was enough. It had heated seats, full leather interior, 4-speed automatic transmission. That thing was great. I liked that car a lot. Maybe it was my first. I had an 89 Volvo before that. But I think that was the first one I actually had any say in that wasn't just a hand-me-down.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
I had a Volvo V70 Cross Country, 2000 in green with a tan interior.
Yeah.
The 5-cylinder turbo engine, again, a 4-speed automatic, and a Haldex-based all-wheel drive system. So front drive bias, but it would send some power to the back.
Mm-hmm.
I think it was early Haldex. Anyway, someone will correct me if they pay attention. There may not be any Volvo fans that listen. That's probably true.
There's some crossover between Volvo and Porsche. Mm-hmm. Though.
There is. There's got to be some. And then my 2013 BMW X1.
Mm-hmm.
It was an X drive. It was the all-wheel drive.
Mm-hmm.
It had heated seats, a heated steering wheel. I think the upgraded stereo. And that's it. It didn't have nav. Yeah, it didn't have nav. It did. I don't think it even streamed music via Bluetooth. I think you had to plug in to get music. But I just loved that car.
And that's what you had when you started working here?
Yes. Yeah, it is. And Lauren's cars don't count. Like her the Cayennes that we've had, mm-hmm. I have absolutely loved those. But those are her cars, not my car. Seriously, we've pulled 1.22 Gs. In her Cayenne hybrid on all season tires. Tell me that's not fun. But the
Porsche make a hell of an SUV.
It's great. But that X1 was just kind of a sweet spot. It's basically a lifted 3-series wagon with a turbocharged 4-cylinder and a ZF8 speed is the one we had. It was perfect and it was delightful. And I was toying with maybe getting rid of the Subaru and just getting a cheap one of those to replace it with and just kind of save some cash because I don't love the Subaru. If I love the Subaru, it's worth the money, but I don't love it. So let's just find
it. Sounds like you've been talking yourself into this all evening.
I 2 days ago, I started thinking about it. And then he pulls up in an X1 big motor with the, you know,
3 liter.
Yeah, the 3 liter turbo, 300 horsepower jobby. And it just was like, well, dang.
Right.
It's, you know,
I mean, I think as car people, as friends, parked car people who are friends, we're like drug addicts where we have to enable each other's addictions.
Sure. Mm-hmm.
So we'll never say, no, don't buy that car, John. I'll say, John, you should buy two.
Yes.
And actually, do you want to buy mine?
Yeah.
I'll walk home.
Yeah.
No. You might even be able to trade like a test drive with him for, you know, something you got lying around here.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Oh, for the Speedster. Yeah. The GT4. Yeah. You know, we could do a swap.
Mm-hmm.
But no, I am. So that's the E84 BMW X1.
Mm-hmm.
It's an E90 BMW 3 Series chassis, and I'm an evangelist for the E84 X1 because nobody knows about them, mm-hmm. and especially with the six-cylinder, the N55 turbo 3-liter six. It's a rocket. You can really, I mean, there aren't too many cars on the road that are faster than you in normal traffic other than all these cars that are much faster. But in normal driving, yeah, it's like, get out of my way, slap it into mm-hmm. sport mode and floor. I mean, it's 0 to 60 in like, what, 5.3 seconds? Mm-hmm. And yeah, you've got rear wheel biased all-wheel drive. It has hydraulic. It's actually the last BMW that they made new with the hydraulic steering. All the other BMWs had electric steering.
Tell me about your parking brake.
Tell me about it. Is a manual parking brake.
Look
it
at that.
It is not a button. Yeah. It is a real yes. old school ratchet mm-hmm. pull it up. Yep, it is a real parking brake. Yeah, it's just a great car. My wife and I got it. We were back in when we were in New York. We were in Brooklyn, and we were in a building that had a parking lot, so we could get a decently nice car and not have to park it on the street where you have to worry about somebody going to the bathroom on your car on your bumper. No, this is true. I saw
speaking.
This.
Oh my I saw God, this happen. We're doing so good today. Did you see the fox?
The fox. No.
Keep going. I'll find the fox.
Keep going. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So I wanted a 135i coupe. Mm-hmm. And my wife was like, you know, in a few years, we're going to have kids and we're going to need a car seat. So I said, okay.
Well, that's in a few years, though. I mean,
I know. But I'm the kind of guy, I like to have a car and keep it for a while. A lot of car guys like to rotate through cars every couple of years. I like to have a car, experience it, really get to know it. And yeah, so I was like, okay, it's not the 135. It was a Golf R, okay. And then this X1 came up and I looked into it. I'm like, yeah, this is the car. And it's never, two things have broken in all the years. We've had it since 2018 and only two things have actually broken. One, we had a coolant expansion tank crack. And so obviously that, and then the downstream O2 sensor, the one that's like all the way deep down in there. Mm, yeah. And so that was the like,
of course, it's the hard to get one.
Yeah. Oh yeah. And so it was just go to my, local indie shop in Brooklyn and they're, ka-ching, ka-ching. Here's my, paycheck for the next mm-hmm. 2 months. And it's worth it. It's a great car. I love it. The driving dynamics, it's really not. You don't feel like you're driving a crossover or a lifted wagon. You feel like it's a 3 Series. It's a 3 Series wagon.
Right, so. Right. Mm-hmm. So I was thinking, John and I have talked a lot about us. So we should talk about you guys.
Yes, I agree.
So that's a good intro. But you're here with Colorado Cars and Coffee. And it's I mean, I'm learning for the first time. It's you two that do the newsletter. Really?
Correct. This is it.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Again, we've got a small bit of support staff that helps with gathering some of the information, mm-hmm. the events that we do, helping us to harvest subscribers, mm-hmm. The email list so we can add them to the MailChimp and whatnot. Mm-hmm. But in reality, yes, it is the two of us. We're
the MailChimps. Clickety, clickety, click.
For some time, it was myself. And very thankfully, Jason has stepped up, come aboard, and he's a huge asset.
How many subscribers do you have?
Just looked last night, I believe, and it's almost 6,300.
Wow!
Don't quote me. It's right there. I know it's over 6,000. Right. I know it's mm-hmm. over 6,200. Mm-hmm. Could be even higher. Mm-hmm. And you do a lot of the email harvesting. We bring in anywhere from 20 to over 100 every 2 weeks.
Wow. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'm out there in the fields. I got my boots on, my tractor, harvesting email addresses, mm-hmm. Piece of straw in my mouth. No, it is a manual process. It's not an automated, like you sign up and then your email address just goes into the listserv. It is literally us typing, here's your name, email address. And here's a PSA to all you folks out there. When you're making your email addresses, please make them concise. If we could, and don't do 420 gummy bears, blah,
yeah, long gone are the days of mm-hmm. Joe Schmo 8967234. We're past that.
Right.
Yeah. Make your email addresses short and easy and just, it's just better for us.
Would we get in trouble if we asked what's the most ridiculous email address you've seen? I've got one that sticks in my brain from a long, long time ago.
There are a lot of references to marijuana product-related products.
I can see that now, yeah. Mm-hmm.
I can't say I've ever had anything really stand out. Mm-hmm. That would be noteworthy.
Okay.
If I did, it went in one eye and right out the back.
Yeah. Okay.
Head,
so. Yeah. I got one.
Well, let's hear it.
This is from when I was a technician, and I just noticed the customer's information. The email was buried in it 69. That's, I bet it still works.
What is the guy's name Barry?
It was a woman.
Is her name Barry?
No.
Mm. No. Oh. Okay, then.
No.
Don't ask, don't tell.
Yeah, yeah. No.
Yeah,
I want to know what she's buried in.
That might be one of those questions you don't want to know.
I want to know.
Yeah.
Inquiring minds.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. No, I don't know. The car came back recurring. It was a recurring comeback car due to rabbits kept chewing up wiring.
Oh, rabbits.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
What was the car that had the it had like the vegetable coat, electrical wires?
Majority of cars, it's a soy based
product.
Yeah, majority of cars.
I think I remember exactly what you're talking. There was something different, yeah. But it was even more tasty.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
To the critter.
Yeah, that's why mice and stuff love it. Yeah, because it's soy. It's
I picked up a few cars recently that I didn't even look under the hood. But I'm buying it for parts. So
oh, you just came back from a car buying excursion.
I did. When I got it home, I opened the hood and was like, "Oh, look, I have all kinds of bonus things in here, namely a giant rat's nest right on the top of the engine,
right,
and
right.
They had gone clean through two of the spark plug wires." So, and that was crazy. Just at first glance. So we'll see what happens when I start getting in there.
Mm-hmm. What car?
That's a Chevy Beretta.
Oh, cool.
Oh, yeah.
That's really cool.
Yes.
It's
all that's, coming back to me now. Now I know what kind of song we got to close with.
So that's my awesome. Thing.
Ryan is the Chevy Berettas, what Dan McGinnis is the Porsches.
Yes.
He's like the Chevy Beretta.
I've heard about you.
We know this.
I was, oh my goodness. I was thinking that's to myself, if I bring up Chevy Berettas and one of these two guys says, "Oh, you're that guy?"
Yeah, no, we
I'm
both
just going to lose
that.
It.
Yeah.
No, like,
yeah. No, we're saying that with.
No, in a good way.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. No, absolutely. How many do you have?
I was going to say, I don't think I have to sit here and do the visual count. There's 8 at my home right now in varying states of operation and or being parted out.
Okay. But the Beretta, what was the nomenclature? That's a Z34?
24.
24.
26.
26?
24 is the Cavalier.
Oh, okay. That's
the Z26 is the was the fancy edition. The one they put out later in their later years, but the GTZ was the one that really drew the crowds in, I believe, 90, 91.
Wow.
Motor Trend used to refer to it as a BMW killer because it would outperform the, I can't remember which BMW specifically, but.
The Setta?
I think even in acceleration and in the slalom and braking. So
yeah.
Mm-hmm. It was, and that came, if you got the quad four engine, that came with 180 horsepower, which back then was
a
big deal. Yeah.
No, right. I was claiming that was a lot when in my 91.
Right. Well, I mean, Berettas are always two door.
Yes.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's like an M3.
Their sister vehicle was the Corsica.
Yeah. Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Which is the four door. It's the four door Beretta, but they look completely different. The interiors were very similar, but
sure. Mm-hmm. No. Yeah. That's awesome.
Now I have to know, how do you know who I am, or who the Beretta
don't you
guy
know who he
in,
is?
In Colorado no,
we were,
is.
We were talking.
We got people.
Yeah, we got people.
We got people. We know people.
Yeah.
People. Yeah.
Oh my gosh! But no, I mean, as soon as the Beretta, that just instantly popped in where we were talking about, and that's it's seriously cool.
Look at that one, a GTU.
I went.
That one just sold recently.
I moved to Colorado with the from Porsche Training School from Atlanta. And two of us were hired, but at the same dealership at the same time. So we moved out here together, and that was his car. He had and I didn't really know anything about him, right? And what I remember about his car is he had a permanent check engine light, and I did not know that because he literally covered it up with electrical tape. Mm. So
one of the simplest fixes,
right? Yeah, exactly. That was a super cool car, and I don't know if they're all the same, but I remember his had a super sweet ground effects, but it was all factory. It was a white car, and I want to say there was like maybe some red detailing on it. It was
either a GTU or a Z26.
I think it's a Z26 because the Z is what rings a bell. But
That's what's always funny to me is I was in high school when that car was in its maximum popularity.
Mm-hmm.
I don't remember them. I don't remember knowing somebody that had one. I don't remember thinking they were cool and wanting one myself. Mm-hmm. And in 2004, there was one for sale on the side of the road in my neighborhood, and I bought it and quickly became obsessed.
That's amazing. Mm-hmm. That's awesome.
So is that super cool. Is that the 3400 V6?
3100. But it's a very popular swap and reasonably easy to do depending on the year of car you're trying to drop it in. You take a 3400 and you drop it in there.
Can you go to the 3800 supercharged?
You can. There have been three, four, or five cases where someone's done it. I know a guy right now he took on another group member's car that was letting it go. And he has he's in the process of rebuilding it all. So hopefully, Ron, if you're listening, he'll take it to the track, because anyone that's ever done that has never taken it into the quarter. And I'm like, don't you want to know what it does now?
So the supercharger is going to weigh more. The rest of it, I don't think, would change that much, right? Are those aluminum block or are those iron block?
I'm not positive, but it's definitely larger.
Yeah.
I do know. I spoke to somebody. They had to push the radiator forward 2 inches.
Okay.
You got to put the battery in the trunk. You got to move the coolant tank. Like,
all right.
There's some work, but it will fit.
Yeah. I feel like there's going to be a whole lost generation due to the cash for clunkers.
Thing. 100%.
You know, like how many North Star V8s just got smashed, or was the Oldsmobile Aurora? Those two door, those were beautiful cars.
Yeah.
That, you know, probably drove like crap. But in terms of sports car performance, right? But how much fun would rolling one of those be? Like, we sold a Buick Riviera.
Oh, my god!
Like a 96 Riviera with 130,000 miles in red pinstripes that ran the whole length. Nice. That was a beautiful car. And I think they all just got crushed for $4,000.
Yeah. And I think you're right.
There's going to be, you know, like, I don't know. I'd have one of those out of nostalgia.
So I think what you're telling the world that listens to this, the whole world listens to this.
Right now. That's true.
Worldwide.
We need to start searching for the ideal cash for clunkers cars that survived.
Mm-hmm.
Cash for clunkers survivor.
It'd be like a survivors. Hunt.
Yeah.
Actually, that's probably true.
That's a pretty good idea.
Yeah.
That might be a little something for the garage report there.
There might be an angle, a story there. Yeah. We'll have to get our finest.
If you'd like to interview us, we're available.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah. Heard it here first.
Uh-huh. Apparently, you guys don't do any work, so you know you have a lot of free time.
This is right. Absolutely true. No, we hang. We're here. But
you get paid to be here.
Yes.
You just don't work here.
Yeah.
Well, with the rise of Radwood, I feel like all of that stuff is getting more collectible, and that's.
Oh yeah, that's it's growing every day. The Radwood Facebook group that.
Well, tell them about Beretta Fest.
Oh.
Or Beretta Con. Is it Beretta Con?
It's Beretta, Beretta Fest.
Beretta Fest.
Is that hosted in your driveway?
It's like Luftkugelt.
Yeah. It can be. We have a mini fest in my backyard quite often.
Yeah.
But Beretta Fest is the annual gathering for Chevy Beretta owners and enthusiasts. Every year, our little group, we actually have a club. The members submit proposals on where they want to go, and then we all vote. This year, we're going to Oklahoma City.
How many members and how many of them live in Oklahoma City?
100%.
Our Facebook group has like over 3,000 people.
Wow.
But if you want to talk about serious, half of those are the sister of the guy that owned it. And, you know, and I knew a guy that had one, so I'll join the group kind of thing.
Oh, sure. Yeah.
Anywhere from... 200 to 300 of us are very serious. Mm-hmm. There's probably 50 people that are like dead serious, like myself. And then who knows how many hundreds of, you know, casuals we might have, but we're always trying. The event has grown. It was, I think the very first Beretta Fest was far before my time. I think it was three cars.
Oh, like
three guys met up literally. And now at one of these events, we can pull in upwards of 50 cars, 80 plus people. We have people that, you know, they take their families. This is their annual family vacation.
Yeah, right. So,
aren't people weird?
I think it's awesome.
No, I do too.
Humans are strange.
Porsche people do it too. I have an old Volvo. Volvo people do it too, but it's so weird
to me. There's a group for every car out there.
Yeah, really. That we assign so much of ourselves to that car that we drive.
Right.
It tells you how important it is and how important the work that we're doing is bringing these people together.
And I think that's an excellent segue, John, because that's the best thing about being part of being involved with Colorado Cars and Coffee is you get to celebrate all these automotive cultures and subcultures and niche subcultures. Mm-hmm. And it's like, whatever your thing is, whatever you get freaky about, we've got an event for you.
You can call us home. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. That's so how long have you, I mean, are you the creator of Colorado Cars and Coffee?
Oh Lord, no, that Ooh. Would be Steve.
Steven.
Clark. Okay. No, Steve. That's what I thought.
Yeah. You guys then, know Steve. Yep.
So how long is it? How long, when was that established? He's probably watching. He should know.
That's
He's
a good there. Question.
Hey, Steve, tell us.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Steve, comment quick. You're making me look bad.
Steve's going to fire us.
So I guess.
You guys don't know anything.
So I've been here 2019, I think, is when we did our first video with those guys. In the
one shift, shift issue number one came
well,
out.
Well, not even the magazine pre-shift. I joined the group when I started here ish, which was 2017-18. Mm-hmm. And then, when I started in sales, we did a restoration / safari build on a 78 SC. And we invited them down to drive it. And
it was that, and then they came back for the Taycan.
Yep. Mm-hmm. Which we can't talk about. They came back twice for the Taycan. First one was kind of a pre-pro. Anyway, moving on.
Shout out to Steve.
Yes.
yeah.
You're awesome.
Steve says 2015.
Hey,
wow.
he started that. And
and now it is an empire.
Like, yeah.
We've
I mean, you retired. Fingers. How cool is that?
It's crazy.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
We've got our fingers in everything.
It's mm-hmm. it's true.
Shift, the uh-huh. new our newsletter. Mm-hmm. We've actually got a teaser ready for you. We're mm-hmm. coming up with Short Shift.
Oh, no Ooh. Way. Mm-hmm. Really?
There's
oh,
a wow. second newsletter.
Wow.
Number two, the deuce.
it's going to be the catch-all for the scraps that don't make it into Shift.
Really?
Short-form content, yeah, from the Shift crew.
The only thing we really need to figure out now is how do we get what was a one or two page article down into like two paragraphs.
Yeah, I can't imagine more content being available.
I know.
I mean, the Shift yeah. magazine is so crazy stuffed
Huge.
With stuff like, as I think, it is. Like, where
I think
does
they,
it all
they,
come
they
from?
Printed, they hard copy printed one of them once and it was thick.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah,
I think
we've got one.
Consistently, yeah. they're over 100 yeah. pages. I'm blown away with yeah. what that team does.
Right.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
What we do, what I do with the newsletter, pales in comparison. That's the big boy.
But you got to do it every week, though.
Yeah, that's...
Every
other week.
Well, Brendan, all he has to do is, like, every 3 months he sits down for 4 hours and, like, plays arts and crafts.
I don't know, man. How right? many weeks did he spend building the fake Lego sets?
Yeah.
Oh, he was really into them.
Yeah. Because he catalogs the hours, right? He tells yeah. you how, exactly how mm-hmm. much time each
no,
one
true.
Takes. That's...
I'm very impressed.
I'm blown yep. away that, yeah, yep. that you guys have day jobs. I mean, like, mm-hmm. this is what your day job
I don't, well, I do know how be. Steve does it. It's because he's got an army of people such as ourselves that that help.
That he pays know. Very generously. That's awesome.
Yeah, the volunteer pay yeah. is extremely good. Yeah.
About that, Steve, uh-huh. let's talk about.
Right.
Mm-hmm. I'm looking at some of these cars here. yeah. You know.
A little mm-hmm. shy of the monthly payment. No, they've got so much going on. It's mm-hmm. it's unbelievable just how far a reach that the group really does have.
I'm still blown away by how much car culture is in Colorado.
Mm-hmm. We've definitely yeah. got it here. Mm-hmm, you yeah. know, it's so thick that I know people that go to, you know, 4Runners and Subarus, very Colorado. Mm-hmm. I know people that go, you know, even one or two states over to buy those vehicles because here they have the Colorado tax. Mm-hmm. You're going to pay $2,000-$4,000 more for the same car you would one or two states over.
Mm. Oh, 100%. Mm-hmm.
It, yeah, I don't know. It's awesome. I think the stuff that you guys do have your fingers in, the stuff that you're mentioning and bringing up and bringing to light for, especially like young adults, you know, kind of, mm-hmm. or even older adults that are just getting into car culture, you know, bitten by the bug. It's
well,
pretty amazing.
I'm sure you're aware that at whenever Steve attends any of the meets, he's got the giant tub of Hot Wheels. Mm-hmm. So, sure. you know, we're trying to do what we can to get mm-hmm. him in, yep. Get him in at the early age mm-hmm. and, you know, feed mm-hmm. that. Mm-hmm. That need, that desire to learn sure. more about vehicles. Mm-hmm.
The addiction.
Yeah, exactly. What is in this week's or what's in the most recent newsletter?
Well, every newsletter is pretty pretty basic, has the same format. The two biggest pieces, well, three, now that you're around, sir. we have a listing of events that covers almost 3 weeks because the newsletter comes out every other Wednesday. So let's say it's Wednesday the 1st, you know, obviously 2 weeks later it's the 14th. The events in the newsletter that come out on the 1st will stretch through the 14th and then through that next weekend, just to make sure that we're getting as big of a picture as we can. So you don't necessarily find out about an event, unless it gets added to the list, obviously, you know, 3 days before it's going to happen kind of thing. And then we also have racing events as well, all from all the entities we can think of. I mean, I-76 Speedway, SCC Autocross.
What's an I-76 Speedway?
Is it a dirt track, right? Midget racing?
Yeah, it's like midget racing.
That's cool.
So it's rad.
But sounds awesome.
Yeah. I'm actually in touch with the official photographer for the track, and he's got me some pit passes for the lady and I. So we're going to go down and check it. I've never been.
That sounds cool.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's going to be great. I'm going to go check that out. Mm-hmm. But yeah, we round up all the events and racing events. Most recently, we've added Jason's Garage Report, which is great. Obviously, there's a couple of group sponsor pieces in there. Some of our sponsors have advertisements. What else do we do? I think that's it. And it's pretty short form.
Yeah.
The main purpose is to communicate events. And then we've got plenty of flair and flash with your quite colorful wording.
Yeah. Well, I was thinking, as somebody who'd been following the newsletter for a while and following the Instagram account for a while, I just thought, oh, it'd be cool to throw some original content, something that's spicy, flavorful out there for the people to read. And the Garage Report is a long, we don't have to get into it too much, but it's a long time thing from basically like 2017. I came up with the concept and it was kind of like a failed YouTube. It was when everybody was becoming a YouTuber. I was like, oh, I could become a YouTuber. And so the concept was like, I'm going to interview people, collectors. I'm going to like come to your house and hang out in your garage and we're going to go through. Yeah, I was kind of inspired by like Petrolicious and early Doug DeMuro.
So really you were doing it for yourself then?
Yeah, it was totally.
I got to check out all these car collectors.
Mm-hmm. It was totally an excuse.
And make a dollar when I'm doing it, hopefully.
Honestly,
hopefully a lot of
dollars. That wasn't even on the radar. You know, I'm an ad guy. I was working in advertising in New York City, and I was just looking for excuses to get out of the city on the weekends and hang out with car people and do cool car stuff. You know, I was a regular attendee at the Caffeine and Carburetors in New Canaan, Connecticut. And, that's a lot of C's. Caffeine and Carburetors in New Canaan, Connecticut.
Wow.
The cars you would see, you know, New Canaan is probably one of the wealthiest towns in the country. And just the stuff you would see, you know, multiple Singers and rare Ferraris and rare, you know, pre-war Lancias and Alfa Romeos and just like, and, you know, you'd just be like fainting from the stuff you would see. And, it was just regular people who lived in town would just drive their car two blocks over. And so I came up with this concept of like, oh, what if you could get, you know, interview some of these people, get them to tell stories? Because that to me is the most interesting thing about anything automotive related and anything in the world. Like I'm a history buff. I'm a car guy. I love stories. And, you know, I grew up, my grandfather was a car guy. Nobody else in my family. But my dad only got into cars much later, and then we got into Porsches. I got him into Porsches. But like when I was growing up, my mom had a Mazda 626, and my dad had some high mileage pre-owned Saab 900s, not turbos. But my grandfather always had cool cars, and he was a car guy, and he was a big history buff. So that really kind of like was ingrained on me from a young age about like, you know, we would go, the town that I grew up in, we had a classic car show every year. And there was also like a hot rod show. So there's a ton of stuff. And it was a popular weekend destination for folks from New York City. They had vacation homes. So there would always be Astons and Ferraris and, you know, Porsches, of course, and BMW. I remember the first BMW, the first E46 M3 I ever saw. It was black with a red interior, and it was this guy, you know, cool guy from New York City, right? Like, you know, black shirt, black sweater, you know, black pants. And he's just slipping out of this E46 M3 convertible stick with, you know, gorgeous woman. And I'm like working across the street at a restaurant, sweating in the middle of summer. And I'm, you know, got soy sauce and stuff all over my apron. And I'm just like, oh, that's cool. Like that to me was like, that's cool. That, you know. You can't get cooler than that.
A good scene.
Yes.
You want to put yourself there.
Yes. I was like, I wanted to be that guy. Mm-hmm. Of course, now you couldn't pay me to buy a new BMW because they're all so ugly. Anyway, sorry. We won't get you canceled. But yeah, so that
Porsche show. We're good.
Yeah. Yeah. Right. So yeah, that was kind of my impetus. I always had an interest in writing. I grew up reading Car and Driver, Automobile Magazine, Road and Track, just anything. You know, my dad and my uncle are both in healthcare, and so in their waiting rooms, they always had all the magazines. So I had every magazine every month without even subscribing to it. Mm-hmm. And so it was just like, you know, I loved reading, Ezra Dyer, and I loved reading Brock Yates, and just all those, you know, all those guys, and just, you know, not only for the car stuff, but also for their actual literary value. Mm-hmm. You know, like Brock Yates was legitimately a great journalist. Mm-hmm. Fun fact, my friend Bob, who was here back in February, he owns some of Brock Yates' patio furniture and some of Brock Yates' sweaters. Brock, his parents
and the sweaters.
Up. Yeah, yeah.
That's
you don't
pretty
get
cool.
Any more, yeah. Any more close than that?
No.
Oh, it's getting tight. Yeah. Yeah. No. Yeah. Brock Yates and his wife Pamela, they lived up by Buffalo, New York, and my buddy Bob, his parents live up there. And so after Brock died, R.I.P. Brock Yates. His wife Pamela was doing an estate sale, and so they had my buddy Bob, his parents rolled up and bought the patio furniture and some sweaters and some artwork and this and that. So shout out Bob, shout out Mr. and Mrs. Roland if you're watching Brock Yates' stuff.
It's crazy to me, like, that he could live in Buffalo, New York and still do the job he did, because now you think of, like, I don't know how you can be an automotive journalist and not live in California or Detroit, is what it feels like to me. You know, I mean, or you could be, you know, Top Gear or Harry Metcalf, you know, but it just seems like it's become so centralized, and that's probably a lot easier for the manufacturers because they can have press fleets kind of in smaller locations, but I don't know. That's just an interesting observation. That
I mean, Car and Driver, they were headquartered in Manhattan. Car and Driver,
yeah.
And that's actually my original interest in writing kind of got started after college. I graduated in 2008, so yeah, I'm a little bit old, and I graduated right into the recession. And so I had a summer job, retail job in New York City that became a 2-year thing, and selling suits in Midtown Manhattan. And I have some stories about that.
Wait, did you say you graduated college in 2008?
That makes him old.
You're kind of old.
And you think you're uh-huh. old.
Yeah. Yep. We should. You want me to just mute his microphone? All right. Now nobody can hear what he has to say for the rest of the show. Let's bring it back to the adults in the room.
The grown-ups are speaking.
Yes, exactly. Jeez.
I might be a millennial, but I self-identify as a boomer.
Yeah.
So,
okay. All right.
No. So yeah, actually, I did an unpaid internship for while I was working at the suit store for this. It was a blog, right? Because everything back in 2008 was a blog. It was called 0-60 Mag, and it was with Michael Crenshaw and Mike Spinelli.
Mm-hmm.
And they very shortly after I started, I did a weekend column for them that was just like top 10 lists. So it was these punchy little silly little top 10 lists.
Clickbait.
Yeah.
We call you clickbait.
Yeah. I was clickbaity. Yeah. I was that. But yeah, so I did that for maybe five months, and then their publisher pulled their funding and they went under.
It's funny how those lists are coming back. The Smoking Tire guys have been doing like their top 5 and top 10 and top 3 whatevers.
Yeah.
And, you know, I joke that it's clickbaity because you always want to click on it. But I think it's interesting because, you know, you get somebody's take on what's the best or what's the worst. And I feel like every time I saw one of those, you see something that reminds you, you know, that brings your mind up on whatever it is. So,
and actually, I want to start incorporating, now that we've got this second newsletter, the Deuce Short Shift, coming out, I want to find out ways to incorporate more audience interaction with the readership, right? So I want to see if we can do like polls, or if we can do, you know, something where we get the audience's response. So like,
come on now, you came up with a real fancy term, remember?
For the, it was letters to the carburetors.
This is why he's in marketing.
I guess so, yeah.
Mm-hmm. This is why they pay me the big bucks. If my boss is watching. Hi, Chris.
Yeah.
Right.
You think we get a lot more reach than we really do.
Just it's to Steve. Be fair. It's a view right? account, yeah. Steve? Yeah.
It's actually, there's quite a lot of interaction lot, on yeah. this one. We've got mm-hmm. people waving and yeah, yeah. people mm-hmm. saying that they graduated in 1983. And Steve's alpha graduated before you did. So, yeah.
Fair enough. Yeah. I've been spreading as I've been hanging out with my dad and his Porsche friends this last month doing some trips with my dad. I have been spreading the word amongst the Porsche buddies to be like, you should listen to First Dibs. Colorado. Mm-hmm. So you probably have two more viewers.
It shows.
Yeah, absolutely.
We appreciate that. Yeah, we'll cut you in on our royalties.
Yeah.
Yeah. You can retire yeah. between yeah. that yeah. and
it's
newsletter.
It's pretty sure. much like volunteering yeah. as well. Yeah.
Uh-huh. Yes. That's cool. So you wrote for Spinelli mm-hmm. on his kind of first thing before Jalopnik hit?
Met him once, yeah.
Yeah.
Had one face-to-face yep. with yep. him. And it was, they pulled the plug and then mm-hmm. I sold suits. And then I woke up one day and was like, God, I don't want to work in retail and sell suits anymore. Mm-hmm. And I had a client of mine, good client, who worked in media. He was an account executive at Turner back in the day when it was called Turner. and they, and he pulled me aside one day and he was like, hey, he's like, do you want a job? I was like, yes, yes,
yes, I do. I want
a job. Pardon me, I have a job, sir. I will be just right. fine.
But like, I want a job in an office.
Yeah, yeah. yeah.
I want a desk like this. Yeah. You know, mm-hmm. I don't want to be yelled at by people. And mm-hmm. I had a guy come in one time in the suit store. Our company was in no way, shape, or form affiliated with Nordstrom, and he was very angry and livid that he couldn't use his Nordstrom gift card at our store. And yeah. our mm-hmm. store didn't sound like Nordstrom. The name was nothing mm-hmm. like Nordstrom.
Welcome to retail.
Yeah, yeah. And the guy was like, blood vessels popping out of his neck, angry, spitting in my face, why we wouldn't accept the gift card. I said, we're not.
Yeah. Sir, do you see Nordstrom on the door yeah. or the mm-hmm. building anywhere?
Yeah. But yeah, so he got me into advertising. He got me an interview at least, and then been in advertising ever since. And yeah, cars have always been a thing. It was with my grandfather. My grandfather was just a big car guy. And my grandfather's one of my big role models and heroes in my life. I mean, he was literally not as tall as John is here. See, I worked that in, Steve. I worked in how tall John was. My grandfather was a taller guy. And just a big personality. And yeah, cars, he had a... Oh, he was original owner DeLorean, DMC-12. He had a Lancia Scorpion. He had multiple Jaguars of the straight six and the V12 varieties. I mean, he was mostly a Jag guy, and then he mm-hmm. dabbled in other cars. But cars and golf were his thing. Golf never, that didn't rub off. Golf is like, I can't be bothered.
It's not for everybody.
I was just thinking we should have a Colorado Cars and Coffee/First Dibs golf tournament.
Oh yeah,
best ball,
best yeah right yeah that's how you do it.
Yeah, I think that'd be a blast.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So all right, somebody take my notes and go make that happen.
And those of us that don't golf can hang out in the
No, you still golf.
We'll drink the that's the fun part.
We do it at a executive par 3 course.
Yeah. That means short
nine holes.
Yeah. I think that'd be really fun.
It would be fun.
It'd be mm-hmm. good way. We could rotate groups every hole.
Oh, that'd be kind of interesting.
I don't know how you'd do that, but
it just two hang behind.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Take note, Steve, you've been called out.
So it's like two play through and yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And yeah.
Well, I don't know.
Maybe mini golf.
We'll figure that out.
We're going to draw that out.
That's another big
idea. It'll be like cribbage.
Right. We'll invite Usher.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, Usher's going to be there.
Usher will be there.
Right. Yay.
Yeah, exactly.
All right.
I want to play the Super Bowl.
So what do you think? We're like almost at time. Are there things that you guys want to plug, your Instagrams or your Beretta clubs? Or did those come with handguns or shotguns?
No. I do have a fun story.
Yeah.
If we've got time for that.
Yeah, yes.
GM got sued by Beretta, the gun company, for using the name. Long story short, the case went on for years, but at the end, Chevy gave Beretta a Beretta which is currently still sitting in the lobby of their headquarters. And I believe GM had, or what did, oh, Beretta gave GM a shotgun, and they made GM pay, I think, $500,000 towards like one of their charity funds. So in the end, it was amicable. And I just the other day, someone was like, why don't they bring the Beretta back? And someone brought up a very valid point, like, oh, but they probably don't want to go to court again.
Yeah.
Right. So, but the Beretta car is brand new, sitting in the Beretta.
Yeah, I don't know much about it. I've seen a photo. Mm-hmm. It's got a one-off color scheme. They probably painted it fancy. It
says, like a blued? I wonder if it's blued.
Mako blued.
Yeah.
It says it's got the Beretta logo real giant on the side, but and I'm sure they probably drove it around for a little while and then they parked it.
Yeah.
So, it's got a shotgun rack on the roof.
Yeah, in the back, gun like it'll pick up truck. Yeah,
gun ports in the windows.
That's pretty cool.
What haven't we covered? We got to go in the newsletter also, we do a members ride. Mm-hmm. So anybody that wants to, you know, have your name in lights, you can submit via email your car, and it's one single photo, so we can keep it short and sweet. And then like a paragraph or two about, I always ask people, when and why did you get the car? Mm-hmm. What have you done and are you going to do to it? And then what else do you want, you know, the reader to know? Mm-hmm. Sometimes I get two sentences out of somebody and that's all I can get. So I've had someone try to like write a full magazine article about their vehicle, and I had to, don't need that, trim that, delete that, don't need
My
that.
My name's Jeff, I drive a Beretta. Perfect.
Yeah, done. Right.
Yeah,
got I drive it. A Beretta and I got a Beretta.
Yeah, exactly.
Mm-hmm. We are doing some changes to the newsletter. It's simple formatting stuff. We're really trying to condense so you get content. Mm-hmm. Not fluff, you know, because there's a big paragraph that used to be, hey, do you want to do the, do you know this? Contact us here, da da da. We shorten that to like two sentences. Mm-hmm. We're in the midst, actually this Sunday, we're going to meet with, you know, Steve and some of the Cars and Coffee guys and discuss the route that we're taking with these changes. We might start doing the newsletter as it sits now.
Steve says he just approved them. You're good.
Great.
All right. Let's roll them out.
It's all us. Let's do it.
Yep.
Roll them out.
The newsletter will remain as is, but we might do like the first one of the month would have, you know, these two or three aspects. And then the next one might have some different pieces to it. Mm-hmm. We're looking at possibly putting classifieds in there.
Oh.
One to help our community make sales.
That's a cool idea. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
It would probably be pretty short and sweet, but like in that instance, we might do the newsletter as is now, the first edition of the month. And then the next one might be the classifieds and, you know, a smaller breakdown of whatnot, maybe two members rides, maybe something like that. Mm-hmm. We do need to hash out what we're doing with Short Shift. And I would love for you to mention your market report.
That's right. Yeah, there's going to be an evolution of the garage report, and it's going to be called, it's a really sophisticated name, it's the market report. So I'm going to get a logo made up for that, and it's basically, I'm going to be doing funny, hopefully, witty little write-ups about car listings that are local to Colorado. So my concept was like, Auto Tempest. I use Auto Tempest. I'm not sponsored by them. Although Auto Tempest, if you're listening, send me money and I'll keep saying Auto Tempest. You know, my concept is like Auto Tempest, 200 mile radius around my home address, and what's the most expensive car for sale and what's the least expensive car for sale. And whatever those cars are, I'm going to find something funny or interesting or witty to say about them. And then do like look at the auction listings, you know, Bring a Trailer and Cars and Bids, etc. And just see like what cars are actually located in Colorado that are currently at auction to be like, hey, you know, you might not know this, but there's, you know, in Pueblo, there's this, you know, Chevy Beretta GTU. That's
for sale. I already bought it.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Ryan's
I
got
actually
a
did literally buy two Berettas from Pueblo in the last month.
There you go.
Perfect. Yeah. Perfect. So yeah, you know, just stuff like that. And then do like a funny write up about those. You know, so you know, if you guys need help moving any of these Volkswagen Beetles you got parked here, you know, you could list them in our classified section. We'd be happy to help. You know, I'm sure you don't have.
Got an old Volvo that needs to go.
There you go. Your P1800.
Yep.
With the cool stripes on the side.
It's got stripes.
Those are
those are worth it. At least $20,000 right there just for the stripes. Those are pretty solid.
Yeah, we'll put it up on we'll put it on the classified section. I'll do a little write up. I'll write something funny, hopefully, or I'll just get drunk enough till I come up with something funny to say. And then we'll make it work. We'll do business. We'll do some business.
Okay.
Before you sign
I got two things.
Do you have your Instagram thing pulled up?
Yes. I would like to know, how do we find the newsletter? Mm. If I wanted to sign up for it, what would I do?
I was going to say, I can give you the link. I don't know if you want to put that in your description for the podcast video or whatnot. Or there is a link. You click it, you sign up. You can go to the Colorado Cars and Coffee Facebook group and more than likely do a search for the word newsletter. There'll be a link. I might even go make a post now that we're, you know, famous. Mm-hmm. We've been on TV and whatnot. And then have that pinned in the pin post in the group so you can sign up. There's a link. It's super easy. If you're not currently a member of the group, when you join, one of the, you know, security entry questions to make sure you're not a spam bot is, would you like to sign up for our newsletter, where you can drop either your email or the link is right there. Super easy to do. So go ahead and subscribe.
Yeah.
Did we say the website, coloradocarsandcoffee.com?
coloradocarsandcoffee.com has access to everything. You can sign up for the newsletter. You can check out all the Shift magazine issues. That's our central hub, but you know, most of the action, interaction goes down in the Facebook group.
Yep.
Right? Cool. Oh, lots of action goes down in the Facebook group.
Yeah.
We're not going to get canceled.
No, this is great.
I did have one more piece to spit out.
Do it.
Yeah.
As I said earlier, Colorado Cars and Coffee's got their fingers in everything. Just this year, they created, created a scholarship fund.
Wow.
And we actually had a few people, a small handful of people apply. Mm-hmm. Everywhere from young kids still in high school or like Lincoln Tech, all the way up to people that were changing their career paths in their mid-40s.
Mm-hmm.
It was very interesting to read over the applications. Mm-hmm. We did award two scholarships at $1,000 apiece.
Well,
to Carson Holmes and Jacob Blevins.
Okay.
So congratulations to the two of you.
Yeah, yeah.
If for some reason you would like to see these young men, you can go into the Colorado Cars and Coffee group, probably do a search for scholarship, and boom, there's photos of Steve with the classic
big fake check. That was check.
Yeah. That's awesome. Mm-hmm. That's fantastic.
So we
That's super cool.
We give back, and that's a really cool thing as well. It's it's, you know, bringing the kids in with the Hot Wheels. It's giving the scholarships out. It's plugging into all the communities and the subcultures. It's really cool.
For sure.
And we are very happy to be a part of it. And thank you for having us.
Yeah.
Yeah. Thank you so much.
For your on that note, let's watch a fox shit on a Ferrari.
Yes. This is great. Can I, you know, I'm going to scroll over here?
Yep.
All right. So, what the YouTubers are looking at is us.
Yeah.
Right. And then John's and then computer. The here.
Oh, so it's an action
doing
video.
It again. Mm-hmm. Dang it. I don't want to sign into TikTok. This stupid. I mean, you're very wonderful Chinese government.
We're super pro here.
Yeah, there we go.
Hello,
we go.
Xi Jinping. Yeah,
so there's a fox. Okay. Watch him.
Everybody
watching.
Yep.
And oh, what's he doing?
Wow, that is
he's dropping a deuce.
That is a very
right on
beautiful.
The back of that.
I don't know if that's a.
Yep. See, you see that deuce right there? He just dropped a bomb.
I don't know if that's a high class fox,
but
or a low class. The paint just felt very comfortable.
But wait for it.
Redneck Ferrari.
Yeah, but wait for it.
Hold on. Yep, that was the first video.
Yeah. Right. Yep. This is a.
Is it a 458 or?
I think it's a 488.
488.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Oh man, there's another one. It again.
You had to scroll. But anyway.
Oh, here's the other one. Here's the other one. Yeah, he's back. He's back. He's back. He's doing it again.
Yeah.
He's marked his territory.
Well, I was gonna say. Well, now it belongs to him. I mean.
Yeah.
Yeah. This is just my. I mean, why would a fox do that twice?
What the fuck?
Like I said,
I know.
It's something about the feel of that the glasswork under the paws.
It's got to be
very relaxing.
I know.
It's warm. It's something off like, of the V8, the cross plane.
This is gonna smell good. I'm just gonna walk over.
That is awesome.
Maybe he just always used to. Maybe that was where he pooped, and now there's just a Ferrari there.
Now there's a Ferrari there.
Yeah, there could be.
Yeah. So
I mean, you should probably park the Ferrari inside the garage and not leave it in the driveway. But.
Anyway.
Who am I to judge?
Well, that was fun. Is that it?
That's all I got.
You got your song picked out?
Nope, I don't.
All right.
Shout out to my dad.
Yeah.
Shout out to my mom.
We didn't even get to talk about your cars other than those Z82s. but we'll have you back.
Yeah,
we'll
for sure.
Mm-hmm. I don't know what to play. Well, let's do the Denver one. That'll be good.
No, there you go.
That was a good original choice.
So, are you ready?
No. Just because I know what it was, it doesn't mean I know where to find it.
There's actually
he
a
did
song.
Not have that queued up.
No, I mean, no, I did have it queued up, but I don't know where I.
Well, and then you went to was TikTok.
Yeah, we're over time.
I know.
Yep.
Overtime's like, fine. People are still listening.
There's an electronic jazz track that's titled Porsche 944.
Well, that sounds fun.
Mm. Yeah.
What is it?
Go figure. It's
leaving
jazz,
it? Is it leaving Denver?
Go back to Denver.
Isn't it Get Out of Denver?
Yeah, get out of Denver, Bob Seger.
Okay.
Although this evening we will be going back.
We'll we have to flip it.
Well, get out of here.
Well, now it's not a surprise.
Well, why didn't you mute my microphone? This is what people are used to with this show. This is what they tune in for.
We've scooped ourselves.
Right. Yeah.
There's no need to take this highbrow, guys.
Yeah, exactly. How is John so bad at his job? They're 200 episodes in, and he still doesn't know what he's doing.
Yeah.
This is Eddie and the Hot Rods. It's not even Bob Seger.
Oh, Bob Seger right. Bust. No.
We'll try it.
For the First Dibs podcast, I'm Justin.
I'm John.
And thank you, Ryan and Jason.
See you guys.
Have a good night.
Thank you for having us.